to be with you here tonight. It's so good to see everyone. And the Lord laid something on my heart a few weeks ago that honestly I thought it was just for me. And he said, oh no, that's not just for you, honey. You go share it. So get ready to share it with you. And let's go ahead and get started so I don't run out of time.
Belinda, yes, sir. Can I ask you, do I know anything about it?
Absolutely not. Exactly. That's a work of the Spirit. And Audrey, you don't know what you said last Sunday. You're about to find out. In our Bibles, let's go to 2 Kings chapter 2. We're going to read verses 1 through 3, and then we're going to skip down to verses 8 through 10. Now, in this particular passage of Scripture, Brother Hudson, we see the old prophet, Elijah. Okay, and he is with his young disciple, Elisha. Okay, we've got the old prophet Elijah, J-A-H, and his young disciple, Elisha. Now, I don't know why their names had to be so similar. It would have made me so much happier if one of them could just be named Bob. Then I would say, the prophet Elijah and his disciple Bob over here, and everyone would say, oh, well, that makes sense.
Do for you before I am taken away.
God Most High, because up until this point, Elisha, his young disciple, he has seen the old prophet work the miraculous, and he has witnessed him working in the realm of the supernatural, and he has seen all these miraculous and supernatural things, but they've been performed by the prophet.
All right.
Elisha himself has not performed any miracles.
Right.
And the old prophet knows that in order for young Elisha to succeed him, before he can pass on that mantle of anointing to Elisha, the young disciple, has to go on the journey to the mantle. And so they go on to this seemingly wild journey, and the journey starts at Gilgal.
Right.
Now, why would God start them out at Gilgal? Well, it's because Gilgal is a place of beginnings. You see, it was near Gilgal that Abraham built his first altar, and it was at Gilgal that the Israelites renewed the rite of circumcision after they had crossed into the promised land. And the reason they did this was to roll away the reproach of their Egyptian bondage. So Gilgal is a place of humbling, and Gilgal is a place of sacrifice, and Gilgal is a place of cutting away, and Gilgal is a place of rolling away your reproach of the things that bind you. We allow ourselves to be bound by so many things. We're bound by our circumstances, and we're bound by our situations, and we're bound by our insecurities, and by our doubts, and by our fears. But God is saying tonight, get to Gilgal. I'm waiting for you at Gilgal, because at Gilgal I will set you free. And it is at Gilgal where you will get a fresh start. You will get a new beginning. So Elisha, if you want the mantle, you have to start at Gilgal. And it is at Gilgal that the old prophet tells his young disciple, now Elisha, God has called me now to Bethel. Just wait here for me. And see, he's giving Elisha the opportunity to turn around and walk away. But Elisha tells his teacher, oh no, I am not leaving you. And so they go together to Bethel. See, Bethel is a special place because at Bethel, Jacob had a vision of a ladder between heaven and earth, and angels ascending and descending on it. And Jacob recognized that this was a holy place, and so he named it the house of God. Bethel symbolizes communion and fellowship with God. So Elisha, in order to get the mantle, you have to enter into intimate relationship with God. You have to commune with Him, and you have to fellowship with Him. There's too many of us who want the mantle, but we don't want to work for the anointing. We don't want true intimacy. Elijah. Now God has called me to Jericho. Just wait here for me. And again, he's giving him the chance to beg him. But Elisha tells his teacher, no, no, I'm not leaving you. And so they go together to Jericho. Now Jericho is the place where Israel had its first victory in the promised land. And this is the place where they marched around the walls of that almost impregnable city seven times by faith. And when they marched around the seventh time, they gave a mighty shout and the walls of the city fell down. And God gave them a great victory. And Jericho is also a border town. When you left Jericho to pass beyond Jericho was to leave the familiar things that you knew and to enter into new, uncharted territory. So Elisha, while you are at Jericho, remember all the times that God gave you the victory and recall, if you will, all the times when he came through, because Elisha, God is preparing you for a new season, and all those past victories are going to help you to walk in your new territory. Don't be afraid, Elisha. I know you're not going to know where I'm taking you, but remember when I directed you. Remember when I delivered you, and remember when I healed you, and remember when I saved you. Remember all the victories that I have won for you, Elisha. Don't be afraid of where I'm taking you, because I'm walking before you, and I will leave you. So just follow me, Elisha. By faith. Follow me by faith. So Elisha, if you want the mantle, the journey requires a stop at Jericho. And finally, after spending time at Jericho, the old prophet now tells Elisha, well, guess what? God is now sending me to the Jordan River. Wait here. Yeah. And the same thing plays over. Elisha says, no, I'm not leaving you. And so they go to the river, the Jordan River, together. Now, the Jordan River was the boundary that separated them from the promised land. It represented transition. To cross over the Jordan meant leaving behind the old and finally walking into the new. And it is here at the Jordan River where the old prophet removes his mantle and he strikes the waters with it, and the waters part so they can walk through on dry ground. And the old prophet says to Elisha, what may I do for you before I'm taken away from you? And Elisha says, give me a double portion of your spirit. Give me a double portion of your spirit. And when we hear that, we get excited because we want a double portion too. But see, the difference is that we're thinking double blessing. separated from the work of his kingdom. And the old prophet hears Elisha's words, and he smiles, and he says, because he knows what he's talking about, he knows what he's asking, and he says, you ask a hard thing, but Elisha, if you see me when I leave, then it's going to be yours.
Amen.
And so they walk on, and suddenly a chariot of fire and horses of fire get between the two of them. But Elisha is not distracted by the chariot and the horses of fire. Instead, he's watching wherever the prophet goes, and he sees the prophet being taken up into the heavenlies, and the old prophet's mantle falls to the ground. And Elisha stares at the mantle, and he has a choice to make. He can either
pick it up,
or he can just turn and walk away. Silence the critics. You have to silence. went on the journey to the mantle.
That's right.
Around Christmas time, I was visiting my family and in another state, and they live outside the city limits on some acreage, so there's not a lot of light pollution. And late one night, I went outside with the dogs to keep an eye on them to make sure the coyotes didn't carry them off, although I don't know what I would have done if they had, but thank God that didn't happen. Exactly in the name of Jesus. Calm down. But I looked up, and I could see all these beautiful stars against the background of the dark sky. And I could see everything so clearly. And as I gazed up toward the heavens, and I said, God, thank you for the beauty of your creation. And I looked up, and all of a sudden to my left, I saw a shooting star. And I immediately turned to my right, and there was another shooting star. And I said, thank you, God. And God spoke into my spirit. He said, double portion. And I got excited because I'm thinking double anointing, double favor, double blessing. And if that happens, Brother Hudson, I'll rejoice in it. But God, let me know this.
You can't have we can't have the double portion unless you pick up the mantle.
All right, amen.
And if you can't, so you can't have the double portion unless you pick up the mantle. And you can't pick up the mantle unless you accept the challenge of the mantle. And the challenge of the mantle is to go on the journey to the mantle. There are some places that you need to visit along the way, because those are the places that will shape you, and those are the places that will prepare you, and those are the places that will get you ready to wear the mantle and to walk in his anointing. So tonight, God is offering you his mantle. God is offering you the opportunity for a double portion. It's here. It's ready for you to pick up if you will take on the challenge of the mantle. But you need to make up in your mind, are you going to pick it up? Or are you just going to walk away? I'd like us all to stand. See, there's anointing.